go. We finna shoot the video, we finna shoot a picture.
Hey. Yo, my boy, Iceberg Brains. Funniest nigga, the funniest comedian, bro.
Y'all smoke weed in here? Y'all say yeah? You ever been smoking and you start coughing abnormally hard to the point where it make it uncomfortable for you and everybody in the smoking circle with you? Now that's what happened to me, except it was my weed. And I feel like if it's my blunt, you need to shut the fuck up.
I'm an addict. The best thing to do is drink and do vape. It's so they used to say you gotta vape to stop smoking. Now you damn they gotta smoke to stop vaping. The best shit is heroin. The best shit is going to that hotel, right? Cause if you, Mr. Nick can tell you if it's fentanyl or anything. Turn on
girl who had eczema. She said, baby, when you kiss me on my neck, I looked at her and I just told her too, baby, I don't eat pork skins.
You got a comedy show today, man.
Yeah.
So, how you feel about that?
Well, I feel like that, you know, they about to laugh. I feel like I'm about to get paid, and I feel like folks about to leave happy. That's how I feel.
Mm-hmm. And you're currently recording down here in Savannah, right?
Savannah, GA. The Pope is hosted by Terrance Miller and by his cousin, the lovely Erica Green. Yes, Erica, I called you lovely.
That's right. Can you give us a preview of anything that's
going on? I got some videos on the book that they can look at. They want to see what I do right here in Savannah. But trust me, the show gonna pop.
We just wanted to catch up with you before the show to see how you feel and how you feel. We got some back shots of how you pregame. So we just wanted to catch
how
up with
prep?
You.
How I feel? Brother, you got to feel the burn, ladies and gentlemen. You got to feel the burn. It's over 5,000.
That's 15.
Yeah.
Don't tell the world. Bro, lay back, chill, smoke, and drink. That's how I prep for a comedy show. You'll never catch me up there stressing on. Ain't no book trying to get me. Never that, boy. If I can't make you laugh, I just ain't doing my job, yes, right, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, sir. Already, I believe that's all the time we have right now. We just wanted to catch up with you.
OTC, nigga, filming this thing, 10th of Georgia. We got it all on lock. We coming to take over this comedy thing. We down here in Savannah, Georgia, Terrance Miller's party. My hosted by my homegirl, Erica Green, is going down. Y'all get ready. It's about to be hot. It's about to be ready. It's just going to be like a hot pocket, just hot and ready. Y'all just be ready for it.
Dad, coming to the stage, my dog, all the way from 10th of Georgia, right up the street, right now, Iceberg. Thanks. Take my horse to the old town road. There you go. And you from the country. There you go. And
yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road.
They won't let it drop. We are not gonna let it drop. That's one thing we cannot don't do. Girl, the whole time I've been watching people rap and do comedy, your ass has been eating. Is it good? I bet it is. Now, me and Iceberg, we got something in common. There's one thing we can do in Savannah together, and that's fuck up. I fucked up today, ladies and gentlemen. I'm tell you right now, I just got to Savannah, and I already don't like it. I already don't like it. I logged into some shit called POF. If you don't know what that means, it means plenty of fish. So I tried to catch one. So I made a profile, ladies and gentlemen. I got hit up instantly down this motherfucker. That nigga said, horny and will suck that dick on the low. And it was just a picture of an ass in a thong. So I looked at the biography. That nigga said transsexual, but still stuck that dick. So I told him, I wrote him back, ladies and gentlemen. I wrote him back. I said, I'm sorry, I can't do this. Ladies and gentlemen, I learned something that day. You cannot cuss a gay man out. Because everything you say to a gay man sounds gay. God, beat your ass. I bet you can. Well, I'll fuck you up. Well, well, I got off that shit fast, ladies and gentlemen. That was some scary shit, man. That was some scary shit. And I had a gay roommate. I should have known he was gay. Every time I came home from work, my clothes was washed and folded. I had a home-cooked meal. I knew something was up. I knew something was up. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I know what y'all thinking to y'all selves. Iceberg, why you sitting up here talking about gay men and this and that? This is comedy, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all got to get it through your heads. And let's just be honest. Like, if you can take a dick, you can take a joke. That's just karma for me. Cause it's hard for me to get a woman, especially through social media. Cause women don't tell what they really wanna tell. Y'all confusing. Y'all scare me. Y'all ain't direct. Like I was scrolling today. It was on Facebook. The status said, "I am so lonely and so horny." So I wrote her, "What's up, boo?" She said, "I don't know what type of girl you thought I was." So I wrote her back, "Bitch, I thought you was horny and lonely." Women confusing. They are so fucking confused. They are very confused. I had a girl scare me one time. What? She scared me one time. She kicking me out. Nigga, go get your motherfucking bags packed and lay down. I was like, wait a minute now. Like, bitch, if I pack my bags, am I leaving or am I sleeping? Like, for real, what? It's scary. And girls are sneakier than boys. Men, we fuck up. We fuck girls who very close to our girl. We go for the navel or some shit down the street. Women are so slick, they'll have your ass smoking weed and chilling with the nigga she's fucking. Oh, yeah, that's bro right there, nigga. Rub me in that bitch slaughtering your girl. For real, what? For real. And every girl I've been dealing with, something always wrong with them. Something always wrong with them. I tried to be different. I was like, I ain't gonna go for a certain type of girl, I'm gonna go for a different type of girl. I dated a girl who had eczema. She said, "Baby, when you kiss me on my neck," I looked at her and I just told her the truth. "Baby, I don't eat pork skins." Fat over here, nigga. I've been skinny for a long time. What? No salt, nigga. You'll never catch me with high cholesterol, never. But yeah, man. It's just ironic, though. Just talking about people just getting me in trouble. That shit got my nephew in trouble. He tried to outdo me. He always wanted to be like me. We was at the club. The nigga came up. He saw me. "Uncle, what's up?" So we chilling. I'm buying him drinks and stuff. Everything cool. This group of girls walk up. We talking to him. He thinking he gonna outdo me because I went for a certain girl. Really, he saved my life because I almost fucked up. I almost been on Facebook. This nigga tried to talk to the girl that I was trying to talk to. See, I had left to go get some cigarettes. When I came back, he was dancing with her. What he didn't know that this girl was a man. That nigga came up to me and somebody finally told him. He came up to me. He really did. That nigga said, "Uncle, I just find out I've been dancing with a man for 20 minutes. What should I do?" Ladies and gentlemen, this is the hardest thing I had to tell my nephew. What should he do? I just looked him in the eye and told him the same thing that Scar told Simba in The Lion King. Leave this place. Never return. So look, they got into a fight at Church of Chicken. And the scary thing about it is, I gotta confront my nephew when I get back home after this show, cause I got to fight because I host a show called Unsolved Mysteries. I don't know if y'all seen it. I have some members. Oh, y'all seen Unsolved Mysteries? Thank y'all, thank y'all. Thank y'all. I'm making white people proud too. I have to talk to this nigga when I get back home. It's okay to get beat by a man in the dress at Church's Chicken. We all done been there.
You probably the only nigga I know that been there, but if you know we just one day we all gonna, I hope I never get beat by a nigga at Church's Chicken. But ladies and gentlemen, I know it sounds crazy. Why am I talking like this? What's wrong with me? It's the Savannah in me now. I don't got down here. I don't learn y'all cultures. You people, everybody, it's hard to be a thief in Savannah because everybody's a fucking thief. I had a nigga, I woke up one day, this nigga don't cut my grass and charged me $10. I ain't even know the nigga cut my grass. I just got to kill him. I got into it with a crackhead. I only been down this bitch for 3 days. Nigga sold me a washer. As soon as I got home, I didn't realize that this motherfucker take quarters till I got in. I've been Iceberg Banks, man. Y'all take care. It's your boy Iceberg Banks here with the greatest comedians out of Savannah. I'm gonna let my boys introduce themselves. Let's go down the line.
What's happening? It's your boy Sean Brown, Class Clown, the casket man. Y'all don't seen that casket at the gas station. Yeah.
Well, Mr. Jones, 229, Titham born, Titham raised, Titham bred, baby.
Thirsty.
You already know what it is. Comedian P9912 is born and raised. If you've seen it, you already know. They'll run out of money if I run out of funny.
But you right. Hit the stage. That's right. Big peanut, nigga. You got to get the security guard. I fuck with these niggas. I've been fucking with these niggas all night, nigga.
Hey, you boy. Hey.
We got the Rock and Van Diesel.
Hey, but that bitch going to be up.
It was Samuel.
Yo, man, make sure y'all got down. Check me out, your boy Terrance, brother, your favorite comedian. Coming in the stage near you. Now, you know, beyond the look out.
Well, I know you ain't got this on no time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pitch. Yeah, yeah. But take that out that time, boy. What you doing?
Yeah, take out that time.
Oh,
I'm on my way, nigga. I'm on my way.
You bringing the pure pain.
That's right.
Oh, no, that's better.